shot pass, and Drysdale has a lot of room. Tees it up, looking for a redirect from Jones. Tuck's getting to all the loose pucks right now. Drysdale works his way, walks the line. Wrist shot, score! Jones in front. This is about Drysdale walking the line. Well, let's have a look.
Good shift by the Ducks. They got extended offensive zone time. And here's the shot coming through, and it's off of Goligoski's hip. Right there. Max Jones does not get a piece of that.
Sit back out, and that's off the backhand side of Drysdale's stick. He's forced back after it. Terry wins the battle at center, brings it right down the slot, makes a pass. Score! Trevor Zegras!
He has it! Holy
Mackinac! And the Ducks have tied it.
Pass from Drysdale to Troy Terry. And look at the patience from Terry. Buying time, zips it through, and those are some soft hands. Zegras just cradles that puck and just flat out outweights Aiden Hill before chipping it up and over the glove. Man, oh man.
And Dvorak falls down, allowing Getzlaf to tap it back, and Anaheim has full control. Henrique, bottom of the right circle, takes that pass off the backhand. Raquel and Shattenkirk out high. One-timer from Henrique, he scores! He beat Hill short side, and the Ducks have done it again on the power play in overtime.
And he now moves ahead of Dominic Hasek, the 14th all-time in the NHL. Great shot by Henrique. He's thinking top of the net.
Just like the Ducks, I would say it's not my day. Welcome to a new QuackCast, our 16th episode. Today, the Ducks are in Minnesota to take on the Minnesota Wild. Honestly, I don't know how many times I had to whack that puck out of midair before I started this episode. I think I'll be able to figure it out, given when I do the editing. So, we're in Minnesota to take on the Wild. The Wild are 18-10 coming into this one. 18-10-1. The Ducks are 9-17-6. In the past few games, Minnesota has been red hot, especially at home. The goalie Kaapo Kähkönen, who they've developed him very, very well. He's won like 7, 8, or 9 in a row. He's been very good. His backup, Cam Talbot, not quite as good, but still pretty serviceable. Injuries, the Wild have lost Matt Dumba on the blue line. Let's find out how he got injured. It is said that Matt Dumba suffered a lower body injury, so it was clearly it must have been a shot below the belt. For us, Hampus Lindholm is still out for another couple weeks. Milano has been out like all year, but we get Manson back. Let's hope he stays for more than one game this time. And John Gibson, our number one goalie, has been out for the last three with a lower body, and he is still listed as day-to-day. In the highlights that I showed you leading up to this, we actually got more than one goal in a game. And Jamie Drysdale, who we called up, our top defensive prospect, even scored in his first game. The first Duck to do that in his NHL debut since a guy named Chad Kilger. For the Minnesota Wild, they get Marcus Johansson back after missing 16 games to an upper body injury. So it must have been somewhere up here, maybe. They're not very specific in hockey, and that's something that's always been something that I've never enjoyed about the sport of hockey. And then, of course, there's the Ducks being not good. And oh, I should have mentioned, Trevor Zegras finally got his first NHL goal in the highlight that you saw. A wonderful move to his backhand. Now, let's talk about players to watch and predict some scores. So for the Minnesota Wild, there's honestly quite a few guys that have been very impactful against us this season and against the rest of the teams that they've played in the West Division. For the Minnesota Wild, let's keep our eyes out on Mats Zuccarello, number 36, who has 5 assists and 6 points in his last 5 games, as well. He just has that as his stats. I couldn't find how many goals he has this year. Kirill Kaprizov, number 97, who has been talked about for many years. I mentioned him the first time the Wild came to Honda Center. He's been really good. He's made highlight reel plays all over the place. Some highlights I've seen of him in the past. Number 97 on Minnesota. 3 goals in his last 5 games. And defenseman Jared Spurgeon, number 46, is a +4. Oh, and also on Mr. Kaprizov, he has 10 goals and 15 assists for 25 points overall this season in 29 total games played with a +6 rating. Wow. Joel Eriksson Ek, number 14, has 11 goals and 5 assists, so hasn't really been dishing the puck to other people very much. 16 points and a +12 rating. That's pretty impressive through 29 games. For the Anaheim Ducks, Max Comtois hasn't scored for a bit. He was scoring in bunches at the start of the year. Remember, he scored the first 3 goals of our season, which was insane. Overall this season, in 32 games played, Max Comtois has 9 goals and 10 assists for 19 points with a +2 rating. Rickard Rakell has cooled off quite a bit, though. Through 32 games, he has 6 goals and 15 assists for 21 points and a -9 rating. That is not very good. But Adam Henrique has been pretty hot lately with 3 goals and 5 points in his last 5 games, as well as Troy Terry, number 61, having 3 assists in his last 5. The Ducks are going to start Ryan Miller again because of Gibson's injury, and surprisingly, as I saw in the lineups, the Wild are going to go with Cam Talbot and not Kaapo Kähkönen this time, so that would only be our second appearance against Mr. Talbot. We won against him the first time at Honda Center, a 1-0 victory right near the start of the season, where Sir Nicholas, who I have not mentioned for a while on this show, got the only goal in that game. Now, let's talk about predictions. Okay, everybody. You're going to probably be asking yourself, what the puck are my predictions for this one? And guys, I have some horrible predictions. You're not going to like these. With the Ducks and their struggles, and especially getting their butts kicked at home against Derek Brassard and the Coyotes, geez, what a pain in the brass. I'm going with a score because the Wild have been so hot lately and the Ducks have just not been good all year. 9-2 Minnesota. Some of you are probably asking yourselves, Matt, why are you going with a score that absurd? Well, it's because I'm a total pessimist. Well, maybe not total pessimist, but I'm very pessimistic about the Ducks, and I'm really just waiting for Angels baseball so Angels fan Matt can entertain you a little bit more than I can. 9-2 Minnesota is my prediction for this game tonight. And yes, it's going to be a late upload because I have too much to do. And the Wednesday game will be a score of, let's call it 6-3 Minnesota. Let's see how that plays out. Do you think the Ducks could prove me wrong?
Nope.
Let me know in the comments section below, guys. I really hope the Ducks can win, but even though winning isn't really a thing of the Ducks, let's just see if they could score maybe more than one goal in a game. Again, it's going to take a lot to score against Minnesota, so here's a couple of key things to do for the entire game, even if it goes to overtime. Make consecutive passes. Be sure they connect cleanly. Don't try to get ahead of the puck when you might have a chance for a clear. No stupid penalties. And you gotta just, if you can't do all that, well, I don't know what to do. But that is my advice for you, Ducks. See if you can do that. Consecutive passes. Don't get ahead of the puck when you have a chance to clear it out, and don't take any stupid penalties, and don't make any sloppy turnovers. Please tell me your thoughts in the comments section below. Like and subscribe. And let's see what happens tonight, guys. Let's go, Ducks, and let's get a win.